I'm Mayor Tara Veer with the City of Red Deer, and thanks so much to Deryk Engelland for joining us tonight of the Vegas Golden Knights. It's a great honor for our city to be able to welcome you to Alberta and for you to be so generous with your time and to spend some time with some local hockey players and Red Deer families. I love our community. It's a privilege to be with you all tonight. And I love hockey, and we're a hockey family, and so I'm joined with my hockey family tonight. This is my nephew, Caden Kondurka. Caden grew up in a Red Deer minor hockey and now plays in the Alberta Junior Hockey League. It was his dream to play Junior A, so he's going to co-host with me. And this is my niece, Paige Rogel. Paige is in high school, and Paige should be a scout or a hockey analyst, so she knows an awful lot about it, and so she has a lot to say about hockey. So we're like all of you, so hello to everyone who's joined. We love hockey, and we know that the pandemic has been so hard on everybody. People are afraid or worried about household finances or the virus. And we have all realized the little things that we've taken for granted. But there's one thing that we all were particularly disappointed in, and that's when playoffs, when hockey ceased all of a sudden, and we were worried that there wasn't going to be a Stanley Cup final. And so as hockey families, we were so grateful that finally we have the bubble model. And again, a shout out to the NHL and to OEG and all partners, and to everyone in the Eastern Division as well for having the NHL bubble. And so tonight we are so privileged to have Deryk with us, because the NHL is bringing the bubble to the people and giving us all a little piece of normal. So a couple things I just want to touch about: how much Red Deer loves hockey. So as mentioned, Red Deer's a sport community, but we especially love hockey. We've been proud to be able to host hometown hockey a couple of times. We hosted Memorial Cup in 2016, the Esso Cup, of course, supporting girls in hockey. We're the host city for the WHL Draft and Awards. We hosted the Canada Winter Games, the Hlinka Gretzky Cup. And of course, we're the very proud host city to partner with the Red Deer Rebels, our very own WHL team, and Oilers Entertainment Group to host World Juniors. And so we're really crossing our fingers, hoping that we're still able to be the proud host for the 2020-2021 World Juniors. But before we get to juniors, we of course have playoffs. And so with that, on behalf of the City of Red Deer and the people of Alberta, welcome to Deryk. We hope you're enjoying the very small part of our province that you're able to experience in the bubble. And we look forward to spending time with you, and just want to say thank you for your generosity. We know you're making sacrifices of time with your family and with your teammates to be with us here tonight. And so we want to thank you for that.
Thank you to Mayor Tara Veer for introducing herself as well as Red Deer. And a big thank you to Deryk Engelland from the Vegas Golden Knights for taking his time. Deryk, I'll kick it off to you. I'm sure everyone here is dying to know how it's going in the hub, how you're doing. If you could just give everyone a little rundown.
It's going good. Like everyone said, the NHL has done a fabulous job with setting everything up. You know, making it safe for everyone here in the bubble, and trying to get things for you to do. So it's, you know, this is nice seeing all the kids, all the families sitting at home on the couches. I really miss that part, that's for sure. But no, it's good. You know, the first few days, it was a little bit of an adjustment. I guess some of the guys compared it kind of to Olympic Village type things, and I've never been part of that, but once you get used to it, seeing the other teams and stuff, it's, you know, we're almost 6 weeks in, and it's, you know, it's normal life now, I guess you can say. You know, it's basically very similar to being on the road without the, I guess, freedom to leave the hotel and go do whatever you wanted. But like I said, there's, you know, there's golf simulators, four golf simulators around the rink that we've got some good use out of. you try to do what you can. You try to talk to your family as much as possible, lots of FaceTime, and just try to keep busy. Reading lots of books, which you might not have the time to do when you're at home. So enjoying that time.
And I got to imagine that, your body isn't necessarily as tired taking out the flying, right?
Yeah, it's definitely, you can get in that, almost that summer routine with your sleeping, your eating, your working out, is a little different, but, you're not finishing game at 11 o'clock and having to bus to the plane and get in at 3 in the morning, 4 in the morning, and then be up at 9 the next morning to get to practice before the next game. So that definitely takes a lot of the stress and the wear and tear, the extra wear and tear on your body that you have, traveling city to city. You don't really have control of that. So it's nice. You get, for the most part, good sleeps almost every night.
So you're from Alberta. So how is it being in Alberta, but not in Alberta?
Yeah, I was born here in Edmonton. I lived in the area more or less until grade 6 and then moved to BC. But, I lived in Marathorpe, White. My dad moved around a lot for work. So Thorsby, Marathorpe, Whitecourt, San Gudo, Leduc, all over the place. It's nice being back. I loved it here, my time here. My auntie and uncle have a farm in Thorsby that I worked on every summer. So that's only an hour away, but it's nice getting back here. We've been fortunate enough to get out on the golf course twice now, and just to get out and get the fresh air, and just nice to get back home.
Absolutely. Some of our participants have a few questions for you. So Avery Bunziak, are you wearing a Knights jersey right now?
Yeah, I like it. Knights jersey, Knights hat.
So you can go ahead and ask your question.
What is the best diet and exercise to maximize endurance during sports?
Well, I think it's different for most people. I think if you keep 5-6 days a week steady to a good healthy diet of, a good mix of, everything. But you definitely need that... cheat meal or cheat day where, it keeps you in line, you get to enjoy that, that one day, but then get back to work, come the next day. And, for exercise, I think it's everything. For me, a big part of my, getting to this was, working on my quickness. That was always a factor when I was in juniors and coming up through the minors, is I wasn't fast enough. So, working on that every day helped, and getting a trainer and having him put a program together for meals and working out 5-6 days a week was huge. I have to give props to my wife. She told me to get a trainer, and he would get my diet in and my training done, and she would do all the work that summer, and it paid off. That year I made Pittsburgh, and I couldn't have done it without her.
Thanks, Avery. So next we're going to go to Tristan Litzenberg.
If you could go back in time, what would you tell your younger self?
God, I probably would have, back in time, I probably would have, it's different now. You go from now, I'm 38 now. So from now to back when I grew up, it's a big difference. I probably would have first and foremost said, tried a little harder in school. I don't think looking back now, I put a full effort into that. And, when I was coming up through juniors, working out wasn't quite, you didn't have a summer schedule of training and eating well, you kind of finished hockey and then you went and did other things, enjoyed your summer. And now I was kind of at the beginning of the verge of people starting to work out. So I probably would have worked out a little harder earlier in my teen years to get ready for what is to come.
Okay. Emerson Donahue.
What is your go-to game day song?
Oh, that's tough. Driving to the rink for the game, I would say Kind of depends on the mood, but I'm going to probably go with, some 90s rock, probably like Rage Against the Machine or maybe Metallica, something along those lines.
Okay, and we're going to do one more question, and that is going to be from Lucas Zimmerman.
What would you say is the most important skill to work on so you can be a strong player that is hard to play against?
I think the biggest thing is your work ethic. Work hard. You can always get better with your skills and your foot speed and all that stuff. But if you don't work hard, I think it's, you're almost letting yourself down to your full potential. You can control working hard. You can't always control if someone's more skilled than you are or not. But as long as you put that effort in and you're trying every single day, I think that that's the biggest thing. And it doesn't go unnoticed. I've been around a long time, and your work ethic for coaches, for GMs, for everything, your teammates, they all respect that probably more than any raw given just talent that you have. They want that work ethic, knowing that you're going to go to the rink and give it your all every single night.
And thank you, Deryk, so much for taking the time. I know everyone enjoyed it.
No problem. I got plenty of time right now.
Oh. Well, thanks a lot, Deryk. You're an inspiration to us, and we'll be cheering you on.
Thank you very much.
And thanks to the NHL and to the Edmonton Oilers for their generosity in inviting us all tonight. And great questions to all the players that ask questions. And I hope to see you in the community very soon.